How do filmmakers create a dystopia that draws parallels to our world, but doesn't necessarily distort reality to the point where it becomes too unfamiliar? Yorgos Lanthimos falls under the scope of such a question, whose body of work has not only provided thought-provoking and original stories, but also one that encompasses a distinct visual language and makes him a current director to watch. So let's explore what makes his films a distortion of our reality, and also how his directing style constructs a visual dystopia, which together creates worlds that feel like something out of the ordinary, and yet somehow strangely not that far from reality.
I'm very happy.
Me too.
Congratulations. The course of your relationship will be monitored closely by our staff and by me personally. If you encounter any problems, any tensions, any arguing that you cannot resolve yourselves, you will be assigned children. That usually helps a lot.
Lanthimos' films will often break a few rules common to our reality and install twisted truths that create a new mythology for the stories written by him and his co-writer Efthymis Philippou. For example, with his film The Lobster, we watch a premise where people are forced to find a partner within 45 days, or else they'll be transformed into an animal of their choosing. And this creates a parallel universe type of setting, because the stories skew certain facets of our reality, like the pressure to find a soulmate, and examines what happens when they are distorted into unusual truths, which will also typically hold dire consequences as a result.
Yes, it's exactly what you think. Just like you killed a member of my family, now you gotta kill a member of your family to balance things out, understand? I can't tell you who to kill, of course, that's for you to decide, but if you don't do it, they will all get sick and die. Bob will die, Kim will die, your wife will die. They will all get sick and die. One, paralysis of the limbs. Two, refusal of food to the point of starvation. Three, bleeding from the eyes. Four, death. One, two, three, four. Don't worry, you won't get sick, you just gotta stay calm, that's all. There, I said it as quickly as I could. I hope I haven't kept you too long.
Not only do his films then become layered with disturbing overtones, it also establishes an environment that's strangely realistic enough for us to feel attached to. Which brings me to the way Lanthimos directs, because although we're always put in a position to observe what happens, he doesn't always give us a conventional viewpoint of the unfolding events.
The camera should be almost like another presence, like an entity that followed all these people and, you know, was hovering above them or creeping from below and always be there watching them, observing them. Generally, there's not many shots that are at the eye level of the actors. So it's always the feeling of someone being in a little corner or up in a corner observing.
The more I've watched Lanthimos' films, the more I'm surprised at the different ways he'll choose to shoot a scene. I've seen him choose to show us the back of people's heads, frame only their lower half, or even focus on just how the character's feet look like. Lanthimos not only tries to tell a story that comes across as unusual, he'll also echo that same feeling visually, because our point of view can often switch from being restricted to also feeling voyeuristic, where we slowly peek into what actions the characters decide to take as they try to overcome the hurdles their realities from their film present to them.
His camera in this film has a kind of a voyeuristic element to it. You know, you get this kind of spectral sense that something is always over a shoulder or watching, or even as he uses the zoom lens so slowly and so methodically, that, you know, a truth is being preyed upon by something other than the physical players you see in the space.
And this can also be reflected through Lanthimos' shot selections. For instance, with extremely wide long shots that make characters look incredibly small and give the impression that we're spying on them from a distance. Or even using shots that are taken from low angles that put us in a position like we're eavesdropping on a conversation from a nearby hidden vantage point. Every shot that Lanthimos employs aims to not only give us enough information to understand the scene, but to also produce a strangely eerie effect. Instead of showing us what we expect to see, like the faces of characters talking or even who they might be talking to, we often get the opposite and it still works.
You often decide to leave the camera behind the character. How do you decide when to do that and when not to do it?
I generally didn't want to be the camera to be too imposing on this film. So many times I wanted to be kind of behind or on the side or in a little corner, you know, observing these people. You know, try to place the camera somewhere where you get most of the information from there, so you don't need to have too many shots and be too explanatory and expositional about the scene.
This unusual look also adds to why his films feel strange, because whilst we can still gather what the emotions of the characters are, we can never truly relate to what they are going through, since the world they live in is an alternate version of what we know. But But this also goes to how Lanthimos develops an offbeat style of black comedy, as even the dialogue feels unusual to hear. Lines are written in an idiosyncratic manner and often delivered with little to no emotion from the actors, which makes what the characters say appear sarcastic, but in their film's reality are words that are meant to be taken as a real truth.
Bob, you promised me you'd get a haircut. And you still haven't done it.
I'll get a haircut.
Tomorrow.
Not tomorrow, Dad. After the party.
I like his hair long. He has lovely hair.
What about mine?
You have lovely hair too. We all have lovely hair.
Lanthimos's works have groundings to real life, but ultimately are portrayals of situations we can't ever legitimately experience because they're constructed films that don't give an entirely accurate reflection of our reality. As viewers, we are aware that what transpires is entirely fictional, but the twisted rules of the film are presented with such gravitas behind them that they create this unusual alternate universe that draws parallels to our world, but isn't exactly what we know. Lanthimos's films often feel like refractions of the truth. And what are refractions if they aren't by definition some form of a distortion of reality?
Πού την είδες αυτή τη λέξη?
Την είδα σε μια θήκη πάνω στη συσκευή που βλέπουμε το βίντεο.
Μουνή είναι η μεγάλη λάμπα. Παράδειγμα. Το μουνί έσβησε και το δωμάτιο βυθίστηκε στο σκοτάδι.